Trump turns to reporters on Air Force One, makes jaw-dropping confession about Asia trip. On Tuesday, President Donald Trump returned from his 12-day Asia trip after visiting five Pacific Rim nations, making big impressions in each one. While aboard Air Force One, Trump turned to the reporters who had accompanied him on the historic journey through Asia, and he told them all a jaw-dropping truth about the trip. Trump's overseas trek took him to Japan, South Korea, China, Vietnam, and the Philippines, according to USA Today. On Tuesday, he finally headed back to the White House after claiming substantial successes for the United States in each of these countries. One of the areas in which Trump made tremendous progress for America was in trade. For many years now, trade deficits have been putting a massive burden on taxpayers, the economy, and the national debt. The president noted as much aboard Air Force One, telling reporters that from now on things are going to be reciprocal. His comments to reporters aboard Air Force One were in alignment with the remarks Trump made at the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation, APEC, summit in Vietnam last week. "We are not going to let the United States be taken advantage of anymore," Trump said in a speech at the start of the summit, according to CNN. "I am always going to put America first, the same way I expect all of you in this room to put your countries first." President Donald Trump's America First policy regarding trade with foreign nations is indicative of having a successful businessman at the helm of our country. Trump has made billions through lucrative business deals. He knows how to negotiate and how to get the absolute best deal possible. Now, instead of using his expert business skills to earn himself a fortune, he is putting his knowledge to use in service of the country. This is precisely the reason Trump gained so many supporters during the election season, despite the fact that he was a total political novice. "That's what the people wanted, though. We wanted a president who had spent a lifetime working a successful business, as opposed to having spent a lifetime in Washington, D.C., pandering to constituents without ever getting much done." It's no great surprise that the stock market is seemingly breaking records on a weekly basis. Unemployment is decreasing, and along with it, the national debt. This is simply what Trump does. It's what he's been doing for decades. If there was anyone who could have taken the devastating situation the United States was in after 8 years of the Obama administration and righted the ship, it was Donald Trump. It's no wonder the evangelical community literally believes that the man was sent by God as an answer to our prayers to save our country. "Thankfully, we dodged a bullet by not electing Hillary Clinton. If we had, you can bet that our great nation would be in much worse shape at the current moment. We certainly wouldn't be headed leaps and bounds in the right direction fiscally." The left loves to lambaste President Donald Trump as a bigot and a racist for putting America first at all costs, but that is exactly why we are finally making progress in areas like trade, an important component of the president's overseas trip to Asia, which, by all accounts, was a resounding success that even the media cannot deny.